Hey guys, in today's video, I'm going to bring y'all along with me as I try to install an SS1 float. It happened to be on a Train TAM 8 air handler, and I had to learn the hard way. You can't use that. So I'm going to show this video so you can see the struggles I had, and in the end, ask if y'all can help me figure out a solution for this customer. Stay tuned. Hey guys, I was here installing an SS1, and when I tested it, nothing shut off. So I think it's not wired correctly, and this is one of those communicating train systems. So let's go up there and see if we can't figure out how to wire it correctly. Okay, I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. I even disconnected my wires over here, and none of this would shut off. As you can hear it, holes there. That right there, system status on, CLG1. I'm gonna have to pull that up here in just a second. Okay, so that status was cooling one. As y'all see, this is my drain hookup, my float switch hookup. I don't think that's right. I think it's supposed to be like right here. I'm gonna have to pull it up real quick. Okay, after I spent 30 minutes in the attic reading manuals on my phone, no less, which is kind of hard to do. I normally do that on my iPad, but I didn't have it with me. Those floats, that is a true communicating system, so I can't break red with a float. Those boards have a specified port for the float, and it's J6, and it's normally open. So the float that you've got to use has to close when there's water present. And the SS1 is backwards. It opens when there's water present. So if y'all can help me find, or some of you train geeks out there know of a float that opened, an inline float like I was trying to install, that closes when the drain fills up with water, that's what I'm looking for. If y'all know of something like that, I have spent a large part of my day looking for something like that and I can't find it. If you know of something like that, let me know. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.